All right, guys, today we're tuning this 1G DSM. It's a TSI, it's 1992. It's got a built engine, it's a long rod turbo-tough combination. I'll tell you a bit about it in a second. Thing's pretty gnarly. It is a Haltech ECU car, pump gas, and then some Ignite Red, so some little bit of flex fuel action going on. Check it out. Alright, so here's this 1G. It is a 6266 Precision. It's a Gen 2 6266. Haltech EFI, it's their 1500, Elite 1500. It's got their coil set up on it. Just, you know, the smart coil IGM 1A style stuff. So thing's pretty cool. 5-speed car. We're running 93 octane first. Gonna get some drivability stuff nailed down with it and then set up some flex fuel. And put this thing up on Ignite Red and see what kind of power we can make with it. Hoping for 700 wheel, nothing too crazy. Car is obviously caged. Work in progress, you know, like always, like all of them are. But he's driven this car, I think 400 miles, he said, before it got here today. So I'm going to jump into this thing and get the pump gas stuff dialed up. And then we'll see what we can make on some better fuel. There's a fuel injector clinic 2150 injector, so we've got a bit of headroom there. Ought to make some jam with it. So check it out. All right, on pump gas, on gate pressure, which is 27 pounds, we made 478, 381. Didn't lean on the thing too hard. I'm gonna go ahead and pull the pump gas out of it, drain the system, and throw some Ignite Red in it, and turn the boost up a bit. Like I said, that was only at 27 pounds, so not a bad number. The timing's really conservative. It's just meant to be a drive it around the town kind of tune up there, so didn't really try to make any power with it. But on the better fuel, we're gonna turn this thing up and be hard on it, so we'll see what happens. Best hit we made. Unfortunately, we can't keep a coupler on it. Check this giraffe out. So what was happening here is it looks pretty crazy, but yeah, made 652, 583 before I get too carried away. So the graph is all weird like that because of how I set up the open loop boost control table. Basically, I put a ledge on the right hand side of it so that it's X duty cycle until a boost number, and if we go above that boost number, it tapers duty cycle out of it. What can happen is if you have the taper too drastic, it oscillates like that. That's exactly what happened. So when I did that, I lifted it, blew a coupler off. So I corrected the boost control thing, put the coupler back on, and then unfortunately the next hit, it blew the coupler off immediately. The boost control was stable, but we didn't make it real far, like 6,200 RPM. So it made like just shy of 600 wheel. This is the coupler that died, this throttle body gave. So this is a drive-by-wire car, I forgot to mention that earlier. And there's just not enough of a lip on the throttle body. That said though, I'm comfortable with the tune-up, so we're gonna send this thing on down the road. He's gonna fix that throttle body flange, and then we'll work on some of the boost control stuff once that's sorted out and dial it in a little bit. But as far as the fuel and the ignition time he goes, I'm happy. We just won't be able to give him a solid finished dyno number for now, but maybe we'll talk him into coming back and making a hit later in the future. But nonetheless, 650 wheel is not a bad number, but it'll surely make his goal of 700 plus. These things are, if you know much about the 4G63 engine combination and then the Gen 2 Precision 6266. I think we just did an Evo not too long ago that we made a little over 800 wheel on the same charger. So definitely plenty capable setup. Yeah, that's it for this one. I'm gonna get this thing unstrapped and hopefully we'll see this thing again in the future and try to make a number with it again and have a little bit more successful time. But all in all, not a bad day. Things happen, we move on. Thanks for watching.